My name is Spencer Allingham, and I'm one of the pre-sales engineers at Peer Software. Many of Peer Software's customers have found us when searching online for a replacement to DFS replication, also known as DFSR. But why is that? Microsoft DFS, or Distributed File System, is defined as a set of client and server services that allow an organization using Microsoft Windows servers to organize many distributed SMB file shares into a distributed file system. Basically, it's a way of taking file shares from different servers and providing a namespace or convenient address with which to access all of them. This way, the users only have to remember the one namespace address in order to get access to their data, rather than having to remember which share is on what server. Very helpful if the servers that the shares are on are geographically dispersed in different locations, possibly even different countries. There are two components to Microsoft DFS. These are DFSN, also known as a DFS namespace, and DFSR, or DFS replication. The DFS namespace allows users to use a single address to access many disparate shares, and the namespace's UNC path can also be mapped to a drive letter to make it even easier. From the point of view of the users, their data is on their N drive or their F drive, and in many cases, this convenience means that they probably have no idea that the DFS namespace is seamlessly redirecting them to the actual share on the actual server, wherever that is, to get access to their data. So what does DFS replication do? And why do so many of Peer Software's customers look for an alternative? As the name suggests, DFS replication replicates files between shares on different Windows file servers, also known as DFS folder targets, so as to provide a degree of redundancy. Let's look at that a little more closely. Let's say that users at the London data center are being directed by the namespace to a folder target there. Under normal conditions, they have access to the data and can work away quite happily. However, if that folder target goes offline, there's a problem with access and the users have to stop their work. And this is where DFS replication comes in. It can replicate new and modified files to a second folder target at another site, such as the data center in New York. So now you have a copy of the data at both locations. If the folder target at the London data center goes offline, the DFS namespace will realize that and will automatically switch the users in London over to the folder target at the New York data center so that they can continue working. This automatic switching over of users when the folder target they were using goes offline is known as a failover. And so far, this is excellent. You have the convenient access via the namespace to disparate folder shares and a level of redundancy so that users can stay productive in the event of a failure. There's a lot to like there. But what happens when users in New York are working on the files at the same time as the users in London? Remember that DFSR is replicating newly created files and changed files between the two locations. All too often, you would have a situation where a New York user and a London user would both be editing their local copy of a file at the same time. And this is really bad because it creates a version conflict. Whose modification should overwrite whose? And that's messy enough if two disparate teams of users are working on the same set of data. But what if you also had folder targets in Munich and Washington, Paris and California? That's now not just messy, but a potential disaster for some poor administrator that would have to resolve all of the conflicting files. And this brings me to the first reason that people search for a replacement to DFSR. It doesn't have distributed file locking, and therefore allows more than one user in different locations to open their local copy of a file in read-write mode at the same time. The PeerGFS software from Peer Software not only takes care of the replication between the locations by reacting to file events in real time, but also distributes real-time file locks. So when a file is opened in New York, that file is locked at all of the other locations. This prevents the version conflicts from happening in the first place. When the New York user finishes up and closes the file, that distributed file lock gets lifted and users in the other locations can open their local copy of the file again. And whomever does that first will then have the master copy and the file at the other locations will be locked. Let's take a look at that in practice. Here's a user in New York accessing the namespace and opening a Microsoft Word document. Here we go. So I am a user in New York. There we go. So we can see that the file is open in New York in read-write mode and should therefore be locked over on the file server in London. So if we switch over to our user in London, let's see what happens when he tries to edit his local copy of the same file. There's a message that pops up saying that this file is already open in read-write mode by another user. So with Word, you get the option to open a read-only copy of the file, make a copy and manually merge the changes later, or get notified when the file becomes available for opening again in read-write mode. So let's choose the latter. There. Good. So we have our read-only copy open so that we can still see the data, but we can't make any changes to it. Now, let's flip back over to our user in New York. We'll make some final edits to the file and then we'll close it off. There. So now that we've made those edits and we've closed the file, let's switch back over to our user in London. Our user in London is now given a message stating that the file is now available for opening in read-write mode. So let's do that. There. You can see that PeerGFS has replicated the changes that were made in New York, and now that the lock was lifted, the London user has the master copy. There's now a lock on the file over in New York. This avoids those file version conflicts that I mentioned earlier that can be really an irritating limitation of DFSR. PeerGFS is allowing users at different locations to work together and collaborate on the same project data whilst preventing version conflicts and, of course, allowing the performance benefits of users working with a local copy of the data at LAN speeds instead of WAN speeds, but keeping the other locations up to date by reacting to file changes in real time so that those changes can be replicated and the various folder targets in each location kept synchronized. When customers start looking at replacing DFSR with PeerGFS, they quickly see another benefit with regard to the way failovers are dealt with. I mentioned earlier that a DFS namespace provides the automatic failover to another folder target if the one that the user was using goes offline. And this is great because the user can continue working, but PeerGFS takes this process a couple of steps further by adding automatic resynchronization and fail back when that downed folder target comes back online. Let's take a closer look at how that works. Here is our New York user again, and we can use Windows File Explorer to show that he is using the New York folder target. If we right click and select Properties, and then the DFS tab, we can see indeed the New York folder target is the one that's active. So let's flip over to the PeerGFS Management Center and disable the New York folder target to do some maintenance. There. Perhaps we're going to install some Windows updates that require a reboot or something like that. So let's disable it. Then say, yes, I want to disable it. Enter a reason like Windows updates with reboot. And then after a few moments, that folder target will be listed as disabled. There. So with the New York folder target now disabled, let's flip back to our New York user and see if they're still able to work. We can use Windows File Explorer again and see that they have now been switched over to the London file server. New York isn't available anymore. We can still open our Microsoft Word document and continue to work. Oops. There. Now, let's flip back to the Peer Management Center and re-enable the New York folder target. There. Now, let's go back to our New York user again and check that they've been automatically switched back or failed back to working locally in New York again. Good, they have. And let's check that the file that we edited whilst using the London folder target has been replicated back to New York. There, it has. Good. So with standard Microsoft DFS, you get the automatic failover. With PeerGFS, you get the automatic failover, automatic resynchronization, and automatic fail back. Now, why is that important? Well, quite simply, it provides the best experience for the users and the least amount of work for the administrators. There are a few other limitations with DFSR too, such as no ReFS volume support. DFSR can't replicate between servers in different forests, and it's limited to only working with Windows file servers. PeerGFS from Peer Software doesn't have these as limitations, and for example, allows Windows file servers to work cross-platform with storage from NetApp, Nutanix and Dell EMC. To finish up, let's take a look at a feature matrix. And I suspect this will probably be all you really need to see to understand why so many customers find Peer Software when looking for a truly enterprise-grade replacement for DFSR. First, distributed file locking to prevent version conflicts. That's a really big one. Second, automated failover, resynchronization, and fail back. Support for ReFS formatted volumes as well as NTFS. Replication supported across servers in different forests. Support for different types of storage in addition to those typically mounted by Windows servers, such as those from NetApp, Dell EMC, and Nutanix. DFSR can only be used with Windows servers. Finally, there's central management, logging, and monitoring. Now, to be fair to DFSR, you do have the DFS management tool, which is pretty good for creating and configuring DFS, but it lacks transparency when it comes to monitoring what's going on, and it makes identifying and resolving any quarantined files quite an arduous process. The Peer Management Center, on the other hand, is simply better on all counts. So if you found this while searching for a replacement for DFSR, why not take a look at the PeerGFS software from Peer Software? Could it be a better fit for your requirements? If you want to get more information on PeerGFS, pricing, how it's licensed, or would like to have a demo, please feel free to get in touch with us and we'd be happy to help. You can find a local peer office for your area by browsing to peersoftware.com/contact. I hope this has been helpful, and if you want to get in touch, we'll look forward to hearing from you.